On November 14th of 2022, the U.S. Geological Survey posted a special information statement on a volcano in the Northern Mariana Islands. They stated that the Ahyi Seamount volcano was most likely erupting and has been since perhaps mid-October. Although the ongoing eruption has not been directly observed, there is abundant evidence that it is ongoing at a volcano with a summit depth of 137 meters or 449 feet below sea level. Hydroacoustic signals have for nearly a month been detected, which were consistent with a submarine volcanic eruption in the vicinity of the Ahyi Seamount. Such stations are widely used to attribute volcanic eruptions which would otherwise be difficult to directly observe. Additionally, seismic signals also appear to be originating from the same source. And, on November 6th, patches of green-tinted discolored water were observed from satellite which originated from the volcano. Water discoloration is often used as evidence of an ongoing volcanic eruption, such as during the 2011 submarine eruption of El Hierro in the Canary Islands. Altogether, all of this evidence means that the Ahyi Seamount is the fifth volcano to be actively erupting in the United States. It joins the Pavlov, Great Sitkin, and Semisipochne volcanoes in Alaska alongside the Kilauea volcano in Hawaii. For context, the Ahyi Seamount volcano is located on the eastern edge of the Philippine Sea, where it is 468 miles north of the island territory of Guam. Ahyi is one of 19 volcanoes considered to be active by the U.S. Geological Survey in the U.S. Northern Mariana Islands, with the Farallon de Pajaros volcano to the northwest and the Supply Reef and Mog Island volcanoes to the south. While both the Farallon de Pajaros and Mog volcanoes do have islands, no one lives on them at the present. Like other volcanoes in the Northern Mariana Islands, Ahyi exists due to a tectonic plate collision to the east. There, the Pacific Plate is subducting underneath the Mariana Plate. The melted material from this collision then migrates upwards until it erupts onto the surface, forming a chain of volcanoes. Although the age of Ahyi volcano is unclear, it could be both described as a shallow submarine volcano and a stratovolcano. At the present, an eruption cannot yet be definitively confirmed, but in all likelihood one is ongoing. This eruption is likely a small effusive event, much like seen at prior eruptions of the volcano formerly known as Lauihi in Hawaii, where lobes of low or medium silica lava are flowing onto the existing volcanic edifice, forming pillow basalt. Due to the low resolution of current data, we are unsure whether an eruption is originating from Ahyi's summit or one of its flank vents. In other words, an eruption could be occurring at a depth of anywhere between 449 and 9,800 feet. Although this latest eruption could result in a hazard such as a small landslide-generated tsunami, there is not any evidence which points towards this occurring. And, since the eruption has been ongoing for approximately 1 month, it might be coming to an end. In the last 4 days, the U.S. Geological Survey has reported a declining number of hydroacoustic signals, possibly signaling that the eruption which was only recently detected is decreasing in eruptive intensity. This activity could either subsequently rebound or result in the end of the eruption. This eruption might make the summit of Ahyi Seamount a bit shallower, but with several hundred feet to go before it reaches the ocean surface, it is unlikely to form a new volcanic island, at least for now. I would personally recommend keeping a distance of 10 miles or 16 kilometers for ships around the volcano, as we are unaware where the erupting vent or vents are located, and this radius encompasses the entire edifice of the volcano. Due to lack of people who live nearby, this volcano is rightfully rated by the U.S. Geological Survey as a very low-threat volcano. It joins one, and perhaps two, other actively erupting seamount volcanoes, which are Kavachi and the Kaidoku Seamount. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank my new YouTube member Chris Sonruder for supporting this channel.